Hey everybody, Dan here in the Epiphan studio for another Epiphan U training guide. Today I'm going to be showing you how to pair your Webcaster X2 to your streaming platform of choice. I'm also going to show you a little trick on how you can actually set your Webcaster to start streaming automatically after it pairs. So I've got my Webcaster here. Right now I've got an external monitor connected to it, and I also have a wireless mouse connected to my Webcaster as well. I'm going to go ahead and plug my Webcaster in. It's going to boot up. We'll just give it a second here. Now, the easiest way to actually pair your Webcaster is to use the device pairing code that appears right here on the Webcaster screen. So we'll give it a moment. And there it is. You'll see the device code here. It's also going to show the device code on your Webcaster UI, which is what you're seeing right now. Right now, it's showing me a YouTube code, but if I want to actually pair with Facebook, the easiest way to switch between platforms is just a quick double press of the multifunction power button on your Webcaster. So I'm going to press the multifunction power button twice, click, click, and now you're going to see, there it goes. Okay. So there you're going to see, it shows you a Facebook pairing code now. For the purpose of today's demonstration, I'm actually going to use YouTube. So let's switch back to YouTube. Two presses, one, two. And there we go. We've got our YouTube pairing code. So what you're going to do with this pairing code is you're actually going to use a browser. So you can use, I'm going to use a laptop, but you could also use the mobile browser right here in your mobile device. All you're going to do for YouTube is go to google.com/device. And you're going to get this entry field here. And this is where you actually enter your pairing code. So JDJH-JVXX. Click next. Now you'll see here, it's going to ask me which account do I want to pair my Webcaster to. And I have an account right here. Now, it's going to ask me to enter my password. All right. Now you see I actually have three different YouTube accounts that I control under this Google account. So it's going to ask me which one I actually want to pair my Webcaster to. So for today, I'm going to pair it to this one. It's going to ask me if I will allow the Webcaster to manage my YouTube account. Click OK. And there we go. So now my Webcaster is actually paired to my YouTube account. And how I can tell that it's paired, number one, right here on the display of Webcaster, it shows me a YouTube logo and it says paired with my account name. Also on the GUI, it's going to show my account name at the top right here along with my profile picture. That's how I know that my Webcaster is paired. Now, I'm going to show you a couple tricks on how you can set your Webcaster to start streaming automatically after it pairs. So I'm going to use my mouse, and on my Webcaster user interface, at the bottom right here, you're going to see preferences. Go ahead and click that. Got a whole bunch of options in here, but if I scroll down a bit, you're going to see, first of all, this option here, pair automatically after reboot. Now what that is going to do is it's going to keep your Webcaster paired to the same account, even if you power cycle it, even if you turn it off and on again. The pairing will happen automatically when your Webcaster reboots. So I've got that selected and I want to keep that selected. Now the next option here, and this is an interesting option, start stream automatically after pairing. So my Webcaster is going to pair automatically after it reboots, and then after it pairs, it's going to automatically start streaming. So I'm going to go ahead and click that. Okay. So now you see, I'm actually going to go ahead and reboot my Webcaster. I'm going to unplug it here. And let's go back to our main camera. Hey everybody, Webcaster is powered down. Now when I power it back up, because I clicked to start streaming automatically after it pairs, my Webcaster should start streaming automatically once it's done booting up, and it's going to automatically pair with my YouTube account and start streaming. Give it just a moment here. Okay, now you see it's gonna automatically pair to my YouTube account, and you'll see actually the green light here on my Webcaster is flashing. You'll see here that the stream is running. So it has successfully streamed automatically after pairing. So there you go, it's really super easy to pair your Webcaster X2 and to set it to stream automatically. Now if you do want to pair with your Facebook account, exactly the same process. The only difference is you go to facebook.com/device instead of google.com/device. Otherwise, exactly the same. If this guide was useful to you, please give us a like. You can subscribe to this YouTube channel to stay up on everything that we're doing here at Epiphan Video. And of course, make sure to check back often here to find many more guides and tutorials on how to use your Webcaster X2. Thank you so much. We'll see you soon.